Hello everyone, welcome to Elements of Costing class. In today's class also we will be solving problem on cost sheet. Okay, this is the problem. I'll read out it. Prepare cost sheet from the following information relating to article X. Okay, now here they have given stock on 1st January 2015. It means it is opening. Opening materials, then finished goods in bracket they have given 400 units. Okay. Now purchases of raw materials, then direct wages is given, then work on cost. Okay. Work on cost is nothing but it is factory overheads. Okay. You can write it here. Take out your pencil and write wherever the expenses has to be taken. Okay, now here work in progress, opening as well as closing they have given. Now work in progress, where it is taken? Opening, we add it. Okay, so you can write add factory overheads, and closing, what we do? Closing we deduct. So you can write less factory overheads. Understanding? Okay, it is just for your sake. You should not get confused. So I will be writing here administrative overheads, then stock on 31st December 2015. So here they have initially they have given opening and here they have given closing. Okay, now write down here like opening raw materials, where it is taken. It is taken in note number 1. Okay, now finished goods. Finished goods. Opening, what we do? We add in cost of production. Add in cost of production. Right? Now, here closing also, what we do? Here we take closing raw materials in note number 1. Then less in cost of production. Okay, understanding? Okay, now sale of finished goods, this is nothing but it is an sales. Fine. Now as they have given opening raw materials and closing raw materials, it means they have not given direct material, so we will have to find out direct material first. Okay, so take down working note. Note number 1, calculation of direct material. Okay, so two columns, particulars, then amount. Okay, so first we need to take opening stock of raw materials. So opening stock of raw material. So where it is given? So here they have given the first point, amount is 4000. So amount column you need to write 4000. The next we need to add purchases. Add purchases. Okay, now purchases of raw materials they have given, that is second point. So amount is 24,000. So right here 24,000. Okay, now again go through the problem. If any expenses they have given like freight, octroi, carriage inward. Okay, so all such things has to be taken over here. If they have not given, then make a total. Total is 28,000. Okay, here you can write it is total. Okay, now from this you will have to deduct less what? Closing stock of raw materials. Okay, amount. So in the 7 point they have given 4,400. 4,400. Okay, now deduct this. Whatever balance you get, that will be called as what? Direct material. So here you can write it is direct material. Direct material. Okay, so now we have got direct material. So now we will prepare cost sheet. So write down heading cost sheet for the year ending 31st December 2015. Understanding? Okay, now three columns, one for particulars and two amount columns. Under particulars, first we need to take direct material. Okay, outer column, amount is how much? 23,600. Okay, now next is take direct wages. Okay, here they have given direct wages third point. So amount is how much? 20,000. Okay, now go through the problem. If they have given direct expenses, so in this problem they have not given direct expenses, so this total itself will be called as what? Prime cost. Hope so everybody is understanding. Now make total of this. Your total will be 43,600. 43,600. Okay. Now next step is to add factory overheads. Now, factory overheads. Now go through the problem. What they have given? Work on cost is given. Right? So take it. Work on cost is nothing but it is factory overheads. Work on cost. Okay, now take this amount in the inner column. Okay, amount is how much? 8,400. Okay, now again go through the problem. If any factory overheads they have given, they have not given any factory overheads, but what they have given is opening work in progress as well as closing work in progress is given. That is fifth point. Okay, so opening work in progress has to be added to factory overheads, right? Add opening work in progress. Okay, amount in the inner column, opening work in progress, that is on 1st January 2015 is opening work in progress. Amount is 960. Okay, now make total and write it in the inner column itself. That is 9,360. Total is 9,360. Okay, now next is they have given closing work in progress. So we will have to deduct it. Less closing work in progress. Okay, now closing work in progress, here they have given on 31st December 2015, that is fifth point, 3,200. So 3,200. Now whatever balance you get, take that balance in the outer column, that is 6,160. 6,160. Okay, yes. Now add this balance to prime cost so that you will get what? Works cost. Okay, add it. Once you add, you will get 49,760. Hope so you people are understanding it. Okay, yes. Now next step is to add administrative overheads. Okay, now here they have given administrative overhead sixth point, that is 1,600. 600. So write that in the outer column, 1600. Okay, now whatever total we get, that will be called as what? Cost of production. Cost of cost of production. So make total. Total is 51,360. Okay, yes. Now opening stock of finished goods is given in the problem, as well as closing stock of finished goods is given in the problem. So opening has to be added in cost of production and closing has to be added in deducted in cost of production. Okay, now but the thing is what? Closing stock of finished goods, units they have given, that is 800 units, but they have not given us the amount. It means we will have to find out how much is the amount of closing stock of finished goods. Okay, now before taking that, what we will do is we will add here opening stock of finished goods. So add opening stock of finished goods. Okay, yes. Now opening stock of finished goods, take directly in the outer column. It is 3200. Got it? Where it is first point in that second one, right? Okay. Now make total. We will get 54,560. So from this amount we will have to deduct less closing stock of finished goods. Closing stock of finished goods. So we don't know. We will have to find it out. Okay. So take down second working note. Note 2. Calculation of closing stock of finished goods. Okay. Now I had given you all one working note. Okay, like after the format I had given, so after that I had told you all one note. Okay, that is stock of finished goods should be always valued at cost of production. Okay, it should be always valued at cost of production. Right, now here units, here one line you can mention. Okay, that is stock of finished goods is valued at cost of production. Okay, now we will be having cross multiplication, like so units and amount. Units and amount. Okay, now go through the problem. Okay, now total production is how much? Go through the last sentence of the problem. So total production during 2015 was 6,400 units. 6,400 units. Okay. Now for 6,400 units, cost of production is how much? 51,360. Understanding? Yes. So that is 51,360. 51,360. Okay, for because total production is 6,400 units, then total production for 6,400, that is cost of production for 6,400 units is 51,360. So that we have taken. Now again go through the problem. Here they have given seventh point, finished goods in bracket 800 units. This is closing stock of finished goods. So units is 800 units. Then for 800 units, how much will be the amount? So that we will have to calculate. Okay, yes. Hope so everybody is understanding it. Cross multiplication. So 800 into 51,360 then divided by 6,400 units. Okay, so here you can write 6,400 calculate that how much you will get. Rupees 6,420 is what? Closing stock of finished goods. So right here in bracket you can write note 2. Okay, so that you will get to know like from where this amount you have got 6,420. Understanding? Okay. Now deduct this. So whatever balance you get, that will be called as cost of goods sold. Cost of goods sold. Okay, find out the balance, that is 48,140. Okay, yes. Now next is add selling and distribution overheads. Okay, now related to selling and distribution overheads, what they have given. Now go through the last sentence. Selling expenses were calculated to be 20 paise per unit. Now the selling expenses will be calculated on like how much units are actually sold, okay, not on total production. So now we will have to find out like actually how much units are sold. Okay, now for that take down one more working note, note number 3. Note 3, calculation of number of units sold. Calculation of number of units sold. Okay. Okay. So here you can have two columns, particulars, and second column is for amount. This we will take it on the next page only. Yes. Okay. Now, opening stock of finished goods we know, right? In the bracket they have given us the units. This is not amount, this is units. We are calculating units, right? So here you can write units, not the amount. Okay, yes. Okay, now here opening stock of finished goods. Opening stock of finished goods, they have given how much? 400 units, right? In the problem itself, they have given first point. Okay, now we have to add production during the year. Production during the year. Now production during the year is given in the problem, that is last sentence. Total production they have given 6400. Now add this, how much will you get? 6800. Okay, so opening stock of finished goods was 400, so during that year production is 6400, so 6800 units is the total. So from this we will have to deduct less closing stock of finished goods. Closing stock of finished goods. Now closing stock of finished goods, again it is given in the problem, that is 800 units. Understanding? Okay. Now whatever balance you get, so that will be 6000 units. So this 6000 units is nothing but units sold. It is units sold. So units sold is 6000 units and total production during the year is 6400. So selling expenses should not be calculated on total production, but you will have to calculate it on how much units are sold. Okay, so 6000 units are sold, right? So here you can write 6000 units into 20 paise. It means 0.20. Okay, so in bracket you can write note 3. Okay, so multiply that, how much you will get? 1200. Okay, so 1200 is selling expenses. Now add this. If you add this to cost of goods sold, what you will get? You will get cost of sales, isn't it? Okay, now total is 49,340. Okay, cost of sales is 49,340. Yes. Now sales they have given, read last point, sale of finished goods. Sale of finished goods is 60,000. So that is sales. So sales is 60,000. Okay. Now find out whether there is profit or loss. Okay. 60,000 minus 49,340. So sales is more than cost of sales. It means there is profit. Profit of rupees 10,660 is the profit. Understanding? Okay. So hope so this problem is clear to you all. Again in my next class, we will be solving few more problems on cost sheet. Okay. See you in next class.